Hi, I'm Priscilla. Welcome to another episode of the Myki Security Report, your weekly roundup of the latest cybersecurity and hacking news. The largest known hack of user data in history has just tripled in size. So in August of 2013, Yahoo suffered a massive data breach which affected 1 billion users. But the hack wasn't disclosed until December of 2016. The 2013 hack exposed information including names, email addresses, dates of birth, hashed passwords, and you know those security questions and answers? Even those. However, Yahoo has just announced that if you have ever had an email on their service, then you are a part of the infamous breach. Yes, you. The record-breaking breach has affected every single user. A total of 3 billion people. That's twice the population of China. But if for whatever stupid reason you haven't changed your password since this breach was disclosed last year, because no, it happened in 2013, it wasn't disclosed until December 2016.
Really?
Yeah, it took 3 years. That was the whole point of the story. Yeah, it took 3 years to actually be able to expose this. I actually wrote a blog post about it. I'll put a link to it in the description. Change your passwords immediately and enable two-factor authentication. And if you're thinking, "F it, I'm just gonna delete my Yahoo account." Don't do it. Don't do it. Deleting your Yahoo account is not a good idea, as Yahoo recycles deleted accounts 30 days later, allowing anybody to hijack it. So even if you don't want to use your Yahoo account, which totally makes sense, by the way, just enable 2FA and leave it. Poof. Bye-bye, Yahoo. Bye-bye. So for those of you thinking, what the hell is 2FA? 2FA is the additional token that you usually receive by SMS that you have to input with your username and your password. It's an additional level of security. It's the second form of authentication. What? That was all for this week's episode of the Myki Security Report. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to share it and subscribe to the channel. See you soon.